The bloody clash in Pagalungan, Maguindanao del Sur between two groups of the Moro Islamic Liberation Front. At least 11 are confirmed dead and residents are forced to flee due to the violence. Our very own Lirio Bumpat now joins us with details. Lirio, what more can you tell us?
Yes, Carmina, is firefight ensued between the group of a certain commander, Engineer Alonto Sultan, together with members of the 108 and 105 Base Command, and the group of Abdul Latif, also known as Ikot at Magdad Dua, together with members of the 128 and 129 Base Command of the BFMILF, Wednesday afternoon in Sitio Gagadanan, Kilangan Village, in Pagalungan, Maguindanao del Sur. Pagalungan Municipal Police said the two groups reportedly met hours before the clash to discuss an ongoing land dispute. Authorities said two members from the 129 Base Command and nine from the 105 Base Command were killed in the gun battle, while five other members of the 105 Base Command were injured. Several residents have evacuated for fear that they might be caught in the crossfire. The Pagalungan Municipal Police immediately launched checkpoint operations in collaboration with elements from the 90th Infantry Battalion to ensure the safety of civilians and prevent reinforcements from the two groups. The police immediately informed the MILF Coordinating Committee on the cessation of hostilities of the incident for swift intervention and appropriate actions. Meanwhile, the 6th Infantry Division confirmed this morning that tension in the area has already subsided since 4 p.m. on Wednesday. Carmina.
Thanks a lot, Lirio Bumpat. They're joining us on the line. Millions of Filipinos have begun flocking to cemeteries across the country as the All Saints and All Souls Day break begins. Andrea Taguines, monitoring developments at the Manila South Cemetery. She joins us now with an update. Andy, over to you.
Good morning, Carmina. The estimated crowd here at the Manila South Cemetery has reached more than 1,300. But we're not yet seeing people coming in very large groups or in droves. So the situation is still fairly calm and orderly, even at the entrance where each visitor has to undergo a security check. Because as we know, there are certain things not allowed inside the cemetery, like cigarettes, lighters, sharp objects, liquor, paint and cleaning materials, as well as pets. To avoid long queues, the management set up three entrances, one for males, one for females, and one for persons with disability and senior citizens. Speaking of senior citizens, as we went around this morning, the early birds that we encountered were mostly elderly groups and families with small kids who already came by to pay respects to their departed loved ones and offer flowers and prayers since they wanted to avoid the expected influx of people starting tonight and especially tomorrow, November 1st. Some of them were also worried about the rain, and it's actually raining right now, so they came earlier in the morning when the weather was still nice. The Manila South Cemetery management is anticipating a crowd of 500,000 to 800,000 on November 1, but it assured the public that they are prepared for that. More than 200 police personnel have been deployed inside the cemetery, and in case of emergencies, there are also a bunch of help desks, first aid stations, a Philippine Red Cross booth, and even a separate registration area for children. There are also about 20 e-trikes, electric tricycles, going around the cemetery grounds, giving free rides to those in need.
May mga nangyari kasi na yung bata naliligaw. So yung mga bata nilalagyan natin ng name tag sa wrist nila. Nakalagay doon yung contact number ng guardian or parent na kasama. Nang sa ganun, naligaw, pag nakita na, mas mabilis natin mapanawagan.
Kumain po tayo ng tama, no, kung bago po pumunta. Then kung tayo po ay na-diagnose ng kahit anong mga sakit tulad ng high blood, may asthma po, dapat po meron po silang dalang mga maintenance.
Kaya mas maganda na talaga yung ganito, yung maaga kang pupunta para at least iwas ka sa sakit, iwas ka sa mga maraming tao, hassle.
Kaya ako pumunta ng maaga, may bagyo. At saka maganda po pumunta ng maaga kasi konti pa lang ang tao.
Mahirap para sa amin, malayo lalakarin. Eh, awa naman ng Diyos, meron tayong kumpletong ano rito, sasakyan na wheelchair kasi yung tuhod ko nga may diferensya rin.
Carmina, for those who will be visiting Manila South Cemetery later today and over the next few days, it is open from 5 a.m. to 7 p.m. But do be reminded that there are certain roads that have been closed off and are only open to pedestrians, like portions of Zapote, Vito Cruz Extension, South Kalayaan, and Metropolitan Avenue. So like authorities have been saying, plan your route ahead, check the designated parking areas, bring an umbrella, a fan, your water bottle, clean as you go, and stay safe this All Saints Day and All Souls Day. Back to you, Carmina.
Thanks a lot. Andrea Taguines there joining us live. Tens of thousands of Filipinos expected to flock to transport terminals as they make their way to their respective provinces for the Undas holiday. Paige Javier now joins us with the latest from the Araneta Bus Terminal. Paige, over to you.
Carmina, passengers are arriving in trickles here at the Araneta City Busport in Quezon City. We did not see a packed waiting area when we visited the terminal this morning. Dispatchers say there are fewer passengers this long weekend for All Saints Day and All Souls Day compared to previous years. Marchil Juanillo, one of the dispatchers we spoke to, said that some passengers may be hesitant to go home due to Typhoon Leon. He believes there may be an increase in passengers this afternoon or tomorrow if the weather permits. Araneta City Busport Manager Ramoncito Legaspi said they are ready to cater to a possible influx of passengers this afternoon. He said bus companies already agreed to dispatch extra units if needed. The terminal in Araneta City is open from 4 in the morning to 10 in the evening. Legaspi said they will consider extending operating hours if there is a demand. The dispatchers we spoke to also said that their last trips are at 6 p.m. and 10 p.m. depending on where they are going. So that's why the operating hours of the said terminal is only until 10 in the evening. Meanwhile, one passenger we spoke to said she was supposed to go to her hometown in Albay. However, they decided not to go there first this long weekend because of the onslaught of Christy, and she was worried that maybe there are still some roads going to their hometown that they are not passable up to now, so they opted to go home to their relatives in Quezon instead. Police reminded passengers to avoid bringing prohibited items into the terminal like firearms, sharp objects, illegal drugs, livestock, agricultural products like vegetables, and flammable materials. Police help desks are also set up in the terminal inside and outside in case passengers there need assistance. Back to you, Carmina.
Thanks a lot, Paige Javier, there joining us on the line.